C-O-O-K. Well, my biggest accomplishments were getting my triple gold medals. So, you know, to achieve the highest honor in all three of those disciplines is a big deal in the skating world. And I was one of the first ones in the New York area at my club to achieve that. So in my skating career, I had about 17 years of really heavy competitive skating, and I had numerous coaches. And throughout that process, I had coaches that I really loved and, you know, became very, very close to. And then I had coaches that I respected but, you know, didn't really respect all the time the way that they handled their coaching style.
Counter, cross, toe, toe, toe. Stop. Good.
My coaches had a huge impact on my life. They were not just my teachers for figure skating, they were my life teachers. They, you know, were my best friends. I saw them more than I saw my family most of the time.
She's pretty much my mother too. And whenever I'm with her, I'm like,
she thinks of me as her sister, but then when she's training me, it's like a coach relationship.
You know, a coach is a really important role, and that you impact these children's lives. You know, it's just more than teaching skating. You become a part of these kids. So exciting to, you know, be able to see them succeeding in a sport that I love because I played a part in that success. I really have incorporated into my own coaching from some of the coaches that I really, you know, did respect all their styles, were that not every skater is the same and that everybody learns differently. For instance, somebody might be a visual learner.
Let's take a look at this. Okay, so here was you going into it.
Somebody else might, you know, really need to be hands-on and put them in a specific position.
End, so your pump set, and then wait, wait, wait. Don't let the left arm come back through yet.
That's something that I've definitely taken away from my coaches because they used a little bit of everything in my training just to make sure that I was getting the very best training possible. There are things that I've seen that I really, you know, disagree with. As far as coaching children, you know, they are still children. Yes, they're athletes, and yes, they're, you know, capable of amazing things, and they should be pushed, but they should be pushed in a way that's supportive.
That's okay. That's all right. There were some good things on that one anyway.
You know, you don't see the pain behind what some of these athletes have had to go through. Sorry. Like, a couple of my friends have had, like, bad eating disorders and stuff like that. And I feel like, you know, that's something in any app, you know, any sport. So I would say to skaters, you know, who are being told that they're not good enough, that everyone's good enough. Like, I was always told, don't give up on your dreams. You know, you can achieve whatever you want. And I really do believe that. I believe that if you really put in enough effort and enough passion and heart into anything, you can succeed at it.
Well, I'll just get right back up.
When I got second, she ran up and down the hallway screaming, and people were like, I wish my coach did that.
So I try and make all my skaters feel special and have them know that, you know, everybody's always watching, and so it's important that you're, you know, a good person, not just a good skater.
It's hard, isn't it?
It's one thing to be a good skater, but it's totally another to be a good skater and have a great personality and, you know, be a good person.